We was getting high to the bitch off edibles right before the love, so to be real, I was high as shit. I couldn't even shoot. We kept laughing the whole time. I was off edible. But shit, yeah, I'm single than a bitch. I'm not really looking for nobody right now. I'm just on the hoes.
I don't know, for sure.
We for the streets.
For sure, for the streets.
So we know you're influenced by the Texas culture. Are you listening to Texas old music? Like, what's your favorite music you listen to right now?
To be honest, it's not really even Texas. It's just like, I just represent my city so hard, and it's just like, just being me. But I listen to Isaiah Rashad and Mac Miller and Erykah Badu. Maybe Erykah Badu from Dallas. You feel me? Like, that's the only person from Dallas that really, you know, influenced me. But my other artists is like, just everybody on the lo-fi chill wave. And Drake. I love Drake. Like, old school Drake, 08 Drake, Resistance, like, that's me. I'm trying to bring that sound back, because niggas don't have it.
Yeah, we pushing to get Drake on 6-4.
No, for sure. Look.
We want that for real.
Yeah, that might happen.
That's my favorite song.
Yeah, we're speaking that into existence.
What's your top three rappers? Is Mac Miller one of them? I know you fuck with Mac Miller. I remember I tweeted a long time ago.
For sure.
You like, you don't fuck with nobody if they don't like that music loud or some shit.
Yeah.
Like Mac Miller. Yeah.
Mac Miller, Isaiah Rashad, and who the third rapper? But I don't know, I listen to singles too, so it's really hard to decipher everything. Drake, but old Drake, not me. I mean, I like the new Drake, but it's just like the old Drake, it hit me hard because it's like, three dollars waiting for your response. Like, that nigga just be like, you be sitting there thinking, like, look how he's fucking the car, like, wow.
Nah, that's when Drake was
I relate crying. To that.
He too happy right now.
He was in his heart, baby.
Exactly.
That's what he got his money.
Cause he was in his heart because at a young age, remember he was with Degrassi. At a young age, going into stardom, everybody around you started changing.
Not for real.
And then it starts changing you because they're like, man, you didn't let this money change you. I didn't cut off so many friends. It's like, you let this money and this fame change you. Bitch, I don't even got it yet. I might got some money, but I don't got the fame yet. And you changing around me, that's why I'm cutting you off. But they always want to pick that. You changing, bro. You letting this shit change you, bro. Like, you fake. You not solid. Like, everybody around you starts putting stuff in your ear, which makes you think about yourself, like, damn, like, am I really changing or are niggas really changing?
Yeah.
So I just feel like with Drake, him being in his feelings, like, back then, it was just everything that was happening around him. We'd be with the bitches. The money, the cars, the clothes, successful. Like, that's the success that's all, life. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? It's the rock star life, and I feel like that's what we're doing right now. Niggas rock star living.
Nah, really, though.
Pop star living.
But you feel the pressures, like, Is it
different over pressure now that you top 10 and shit, or is it still easy to make music? It's still easy to make music because I have my secret weapon, which is my homeboy, Sonic Major. He stay in Denver. He go to UNT, and I'm always in like East dorm room making music. I don't really go to no studios like that because I like home studios, getting real intimate. Maybe a big ass mansion with a studio in it, just really chilling, or a regular ass crib.
You can get your vibe more.
That's what I'm saying. And then I like being in a room full of creatives, so everybody like, oh yeah, like, I fuck with this, nah, change this, nah, I like this melody. I can't just be in the studio with people that I just don't really know or bitches in the studio. There's never bitches in the studio with us. Maybe afterwards when niggas smoking and drinking, listening to the track, but...
I want niggas in the lab, bro.
Yeah, for sure.
What's the process of you making songs? Like, how do you pick?
Man, can I describe it?
Yeah.
All right, in the studio, Cash gonna sit down. I wanna cook up. Everybody know Cash like to cook up.
I don't like beats.
She just wanna cook. Producers be like, all right, bet. We sitting there, we cooking. Cash will be like this. Stop. She'll hear it. Go like this. She'll keep it. You feel me? So we cook up a beat or whatever. So we just going through different melodies. She'll hum it. Makes that little sound. Every time she makes that, she about to cook some beat. Yeah. You hear that? She about to come up with some beat. So she being that hoe, she be like this. Punch me in. She'll get up, go in the studio. And then she'll do her little vocals. You know, after that, this is just freestyle from there.
Yeah,
it's pretty crazy. She'll come back out, she'll let her that sound, we'll mess with the words a little bit. Probably like, you know, change up the little phrase, you know, with same concept.
Y'all like basic shit.
Yeah, nah. Just to say, this is like really hit some shit, you know what I'm saying? It's like awesome great shit. So we get the bass, and then we find creativity around the bass. Then we'll put the different words, play together, we'll be sitting there like this.
Yeah, she started getting crazy.
We're like, woo, it'd be good fit. Look, you can fit that hole in there, fit it. Go in the studio, sounds good. We'll be like this. Outside the studio, me and, you know, I'm all, you know, producer friends like Palmer, Jasu, you know.
Them niggas be thinking I'm rappers when I first get in. They be like, this shit better be fun.
I had a dude named Tech, the producer, bro. He made Cash in the movie. First met him, he was real chill, you know what I'm saying? He was just kind of like, you know, that tired. So, you know, he's tired.
Yeah.
She got in the studio, cooked up a beat, and the first vocal she did, Tech was like, he looked back at me and was like, it's her? I was like, yeah. He was like, finna cook up. I'm talking about whole mood change, bro. Like, exactly. I swear it's like, bro, he just like got a boast of energy, bro.
You know a rapper?
Yeah,
you know a rapper?
Yeah, bro. All right. Crazy.
You got this. I'm like,
just seeing everybody's reactions is pretty crazy,
too. Yeah, it's fun. I like throwing niggas off, though. I want you to think I'm a rapper because I'm not. I mean, I can rap, but it's not like on some trap shit. Yeah. It's just like some old school cypher shit.
Yeah.
We got a rap song.
It was hard. The song was so hard. I don't know. I still have it on my phone. It was a feature.
It's geek.
Yeah, it probably.
Geek.
Yeah,
bitch.
Nah. It was hard though.
That's what I was on, you know.
It's like she acting ignorant.
Oh,
I had to do some shit.
Oh,
that was so hard. That was so hard.
Some stupid shit.
Yeah,
when we met you, it was like you was when you before you even started making songs.
Mm-hmm.
Like,
I wasn't even singing like that.
Yeah, Orange Sweater was like the first singing song I heard.
Mm-hmm. So. It was Orange Sweater, and I had D&D and all the other shit. That was my SoundCloud days. It's crazy because when we were in New York, I actually went up to the SoundCloud building, and niggas was going crazy because I love SoundCloud. I'm actually gonna get it tatted on me, like the logo. The niggas was like, bro, we really fuck with you, bro. And I'm like, bro, I appreciate y'all because them niggas got me number one on SoundCloud right now.